Hello, hello, you're watching another episode of Green New Perspective, a podcast dedicated to sustainability. If you have seen one of our previous episodes, you know that throughout this podcast, we aim to explore the inspiring stories of individuals who are leading the charge towards a sustainable future. I'm your host, Dunya, and joining us as a guest today is Joe Chenoweth, the founder and CEO of Smart Roofs Energy, a renowned full-service commercial solar energy company. But Joe's impact goes beyond commercial solar installation. He is also an innovator with a humanitarian focus. Joe holds a patent for a groundbreaking self-contained solar generator with an integrated distribution panel and modular battery system. So stay tuned for an enlightening conversation with Joe as we delve deeper into his journey, exploring his passion for renewable energy, his commitment to humanitarian causes, and the innovative solution he continues to bring to the field. Enjoy! Hello, Joe. Welcome to the Green New Perspective podcast.
Hello, Dunya. Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.
Yeah, we were looking forward to having this conversation with you. You're in solar energy space. So for our audience, can you explain how renewable energy and rooftop solar can help to address climate change?
Sure. So it's obvious for some, but renewable energy is great because it doesn't use fossil fuels, which are not unlimited, although there is some interesting information. Some people think it's going to run out. Some people don't think it's going to run out. I think in general, powering anything with renewable energy through solar power versus burning coal or burning oil or gas is probably a better thing. And we actually provide about 90% of our customers. We actually help them. They're all commercial customers. By 90% of their energy needs through renewable power. Sorry.
Can you tell us a bit more about yourself, how you get involved in this business, and a bit about your company, Smart Roofs Energy?
Sure. Thank you, Donna. We're based in Connecticut, and we've been doing renewable energy solar power for a little bit more than 11 years. Actually started the company with two purposes. We developed, and by we, it was only me at that point. So I developed a solar power generator, which was developed for developing people in developing nations to have clean water, to have a reliable power source without having to worry about diesel fuel, gas generators, or unreliable grids. And at the same time, we also did rooftop solar. And the rooftop solar took off very, very quickly, so our attention went toward there. We actually tried to move the generator along the lines, but ultimately found out after a few years of really, really working very hard on it, diligently on it, that unless we have a very large organization, maybe like World Vision or Red Cross that says, hey, I'd love to buy 10,000 of these, it's a little tough to be a smaller business. So we've really focused on the commercial rooftop, ground mount, and carport solar. We've been doing this now about 11 years, and just very proud of my company, what we've been doing so far. A great team.
And what would you say that sets you apart from your competitors or colleagues, however you want to call them?
No, there's always competitors. It's good to have competition. It helps us to sharpen our edge, and it makes it basically provide a better service to customers. So one of the things that does set us apart, we do all of our work here in-house. We don't use third parties. Very often solar companies will use one company for installation, one for project management, one for engineering, one for sales. And what happens is, end up having 50 different people that are focused on your customer's product, it can be very messy. So what we do is, by doing it all in-house, we have an engineering team, project managers, and support staff for them right here in-house. It allows us to get things done without delays and really get it done correctly. The other thing, we're able to provide services nationwide. We do work with installation partners, so larger firms throughout the country that have generally done at least 30 to 50 solar commercial projects. We like to work with them on any projects for customers that might have a portfolio that's nationwide or even a regional type of thing. Another factor I would say that sets us apart is, you know, we're a small enough company where we can be agile still, very agile. But we're also, for me, you know, as running the company, with all my team too, we really have a relentless pursuit of really making our processes more efficient. And, you know, we just want to focus on getting better at what we do. At this point, there's not big changes we're making. They're very small tweaks. And a lot of times customers never see that. In fact, a lot of people here in the office don't even see it, but they're all important to help us become a better company and really provide better services for our customers. So I think that's a big factor. And, you know, effectively delivering on what we promise for customers. If we can't do that, we're not going to remain in business. We're not going to be a good resource for others. So that's key. I think how we work is that continually looking at improving our business.
Well, as you know, we are a marketing agency. So I'm interested to see, when you were starting out, what was your vision for the brand's identity and how did it change over time?
Sure. So initially, I didn't even think of brand identity. I was a very, very small company. It was me, a friend of mine who was an electrician, and a friend of his who was the guy that didn't mind climbing on roofs. So we started off very, very, very humble beginnings. Brand identity, SEO, marketing was not even a thought. As we started to grow, though, what we found was that, you know, we really wanted to become a kind of a people-first organization. And I mean that by both people that work here, right, our team, as well as our customers. And I'm a believer in, even if we make a mistake and we have to pay for it, if we're focused on the people, it's going to become we're going to be a lasting organization. And people are going to appreciate working with us, and it will end up effectively, you know, get referral business, which to us has always been a bulk of our business has been from referrals. So even today, while we have a marketing director, we're working on our brand identity. We're learning more about it. So I think we're still in the infant stages of kind of understanding. But again, ultimately, if we serve a customer well, there's a pretty good chance they'll be happy to refer us to somebody else. So that's been our kind of a little bit of our go-to strategy. And obviously, we look at a little bit of SEO. We look at, you know, the different marketing platforms that are out there. We want to remain relevant, but again, it's really, I think, still based on that referral. Once the people go through the process with us, they're really happy, and you know, basically, effectively, they are, you know, willing to say yes. This is a great contractor to work with, whether it be on the solar or the financing side.
And what do you feel are the biggest challenges facing in building your brand, basically, and positioning yourself in the market, because the market is not that small anymore.
No, not anymore. Yeah, we probably see competition doubling every year almost. Now they tend to not last very long because they find this is a very exciting industry to be in. They don't understand necessarily all the hard work behind it, but I would say, you know, the biggest challenges that we're facing would be finding enough people that don't just want to do this, but they also have the ability to do this business and work through it. You know, our business, commercial and industrial projects, a lot of projects take, you know, over a year to finish when we started. So having people that understand that and are able to, you know, continue to support a project, even through the tough times or the quiet times, tends to be difficult. And, you know, ultimately, I want everybody here in our organization to want to have an impact like I do, right? That's part of the reason why I have my business. It is a for-profit business, but it's really, it's for a good cause. And that, to me, I want everybody to be proud of what they're doing.
And
so
how
finding great help is always, you know, because we're a growing company. I have an awesome team right now. We'd love to, you know, expand it, you know, probably by 20 or 30%. If I could flick a switch or snap my fingers, we do today.
Okay, but can you tell me what are some of the trends you see emerging in the clean energy marketing space? And did you feel that marketing some marketing initiatives helped you overcome the challenges that you mentioned?
So I would say the trends right now, the focus is on batteries in the market and solar industry, and really owning that power, and not just the solar portion of it. And that's effectively for us almost a second phase of our business. When a customer only decides or only wants to do just the solar energy portion, the battery is something that has a much, much bigger impact, but the cost is also greater. So, you know, working with customers to develop, you know, to basically make that pencil for them has some difficulties. But I believe, you know, more and more customers will be looking at doing that, and they'll actually be required due to local and state policies that are kind of requiring it now. We're seeing a little bit more of that throughout the states. The other thing that we're seeing is EV chargers. Of course, you know, as more EVs get out there, it's great. But powering those uses more energy. If nothing else changes at your organization and you all of a sudden have 50 or 100 EVs out there and people want to plug in, you can draw better customers by having EV chargers and offering it to your employees. And the final trend that we've seen is ESG, which is environmental, social, and governance. That is becoming a bigger factor and really more widespread, which is great to see as companies really put a focus on people over profitability. While it's difficult to have a business without profitability, considering that ESG is a big, big factor. So being the E of that is a great factor, and we just enjoy providing information for customers that aren't ready to make those decisions yet. But obviously we prefer that they say yes up front. Your second part of your question was on the challenges that I see in the years to come. I think the challenges that are continuous, and I've seen it over the years, is the local and state legislators and governments. Some understand it, some don't. A lot of the programs that are in place here in the U.S. Are temporary. So we see everything from, you know, 6-month programs that literally expire. And if you don't get into that, you're on hold for a couple of years with no projects that can happen. Some other states, we're lucky to be in Connecticut, where they just initiated a 10-year program. So we know for the next 10 years, at least locally here, we have a program that's available for customers, that's very lucrative to them financially, and it can really make a lot easier for customers to move forward. Other areas, New York, New Jersey, Massachusetts, and some other states we're working in, have programs, but none of them are running anywhere near that long that we've seen so far. So I think that's just going to be an ongoing issue, I think with the political environment, right? If we have the left and we have the right, and whether you think they're correct or wrong or right or whatever it is, there's always a little bit of political, you know, politicizing, I should say, of renewable energy, which is unfortunate because it should be, you know, open arms by everybody. It's a good thing.
Yeah. Thank you for that. I think that our audience is going to appreciate this answer. As a thought leader in the clean energy industry, what advice would you give to other marketeers and CEOs and people who are looking to grow their business?
So if I was starting a new business, if I was talking to somebody today about doing an environmental business, I would highly recommend that they really look at multiple channels of having business, of ways to reach out to people, which is very marketing, which I'm sure you appreciate. But you know, connect with people that are in the industry. Even if you're not ready, it's okay. Have lots of conversations, absorb information like a sponge. I am always listening to podcasts and reading and just understanding what's happening, even if it has no benefit for me right now or maybe ever. I just enjoy it. And when items do come up, for me, it's a lot easier to make decisions. On top of that, test out what you're doing, with your new business, test it again, and then keep testing again. You got to make sure you're doing what's right, and respond very quickly. You know, we found that a lot of companies that were doing well but are no longer around, they tended to be slow to respond, whole incorrectly respond, right? So basically, dot your I's, cross your T's, know what you're doing, but continue just to absorb information. I think that's a big factor. That's a huge factor for any business, whether it's, you know, environmental or anything out there.
And what would you say to the founders who are already, let's say, in the early stages of solar startups and working hard to get their clean energy company growing and may face similar growth challenges that you experienced? So what advice would you give to them based on your own experiences?
I mentioned it just previously. Find people that are much smarter than you and hang out with them. That's very, very important, right? Never consider yourself to be the least smart person in the room, if you will, if that's a word. Also, really, you know, inspect what you expect from your team. If you want to grow as a company, if you can't be in charge or in front of every interaction between you, your employees, and your customers. So make sure that you're really, you know, on top of what's happening. You want to determine smart KPIs for everybody in your organization, so that, you know, you see that everything is working in the right direction. You don't want to wait a year and say, oh, what happened? Our sales are down. For us as a company, we look at it on a weekly basis. We have KPIs for everybody in our organization. And everything kind of feeds up to the end of the day. How well is our business doing? How well are we growing? Are we not growing? Are we shrinking? And really just never stop improving those processes as you fine tune them. Never think you have it right. I tell customers all the time, we are far from perfect. We're pretty good though, but we're far from perfect and we're never going to get there, unfortunately. But we're going to get better each day that we work.
Well, Joe, this was, thank you for your time. I think this was super informative. And I wanted to ask you for the end, like, how can people learn more about your company, Smart Roofs Energy, and get in touch with you?
Sure. Well, thank you. And I appreciate it very much. So best way to get a hold of us, you can go to our website. It's smartroofsct.com.
We're going to link it. We're going to link it in the description.
You're going to link it? All right. Awesome. Links are easy. Other than that, and you can also link up with me on LinkedIn. Just search for Joe Chenoweth. We can actually have a link on there. I'm happy to reach out to you. And if you're a new company, if you're new into marketing and you have some questions, I'm happy to help as much as I can.
Thank you once again, Joe. This brings us to the end of this episode of Green New Perspective podcast. We hope you found our guest's story and his remarkable contributions to the field of solar energy inspiring. So if you enjoyed this episode, be sure to subscribe to our podcast and stay tuned for future episodes where we will continue to explore the journeys of individuals who are driving innovation and sustainability in the clean tech, agri-tech, biotech, nature tech spaces. We would love to hear your thoughts and feedback, so feel free to leave a review or reach out to us on our website, on our social media. Your support helps us bring more remarkable stories like Joe's to a wider audience. So thank you once again for joining us on this journey to a greener future. Until next time, bye!